What's up, everybody? This is Tito and the Gamer. We're back with another episode of Assassin's Creed 2, of course. And for this episode, we are basically going to be the basic game plan. We're going to make the rounds of the viewpoints. And we'll be doing those. And once we get over here, we'll do this little mission start right there. We'll do a mission here, take out the viewpoint, and then head back into the city and do these last two. And hopefully we'll have time for all that. Okay. We can, in fact, ride the horse, but don't really want to do that, because this way we can kind of like take a look around and stuff, and this is how cool this is. The one thing that we do want to do though is look out for feathers. We can, but we're headed for the first viewpoint. We should almost be there. Just the colors of the flowers and everything, like, really cool on here. Okay, it doesn't really look like there's any feathers around here in this area. So let's go ahead and take out this viewpoint and we'll get kind of an idea of this area. See, there's probably another viewpoint out here somewhere, because that doesn't look right there. Not entirely sure about that area though. Okay. But I guess we'll go in here and grab these while we're in the area. Wait, let's see if there is a horse in the area. Show you the horse riding. Yep, right there. See, it's cool because, okay, you can jump fences and, like, all that stuff. But if you get too close to the people, then they actually, like, freak out a little bit. So you have to kind of prance. See how they actually react? Okay, so they're all gone. Hmm. pretty much walked right into that one, huh? And unfortunately, the horse just stays. So the horse will generally... Oops. Sorry, bro. The horse will generally stay right in the area if you dismount from it. Now we've got some thieves over here we can hire. Which means there's probably going to be something happening over here later. Something else to notice is the what looks like a chicken coop right there. And doesn't look like we have any feathers or anything around here. So, head off to the next viewpoint. Which is pretty close by. We'll take the horse with us then. Yeah. And I'm pretty sure we can all kind of guess where this viewpoint is. So after all the towers and everything and like the main area, it's actually kind of nice, like not having to climb really high. We'll synchronize with this viewpoint first real quick and then go back and grab that feather. And that gives us a much larger area. Now we'll head over here and do this viewpoint before we come in here and take out this mission. But it is kind of amazing, like how much bigger the draw distance is on this. On Assassin's Creed, Assassin's Creed 2 on the PS3, it was, hold it, okay, Via Salviati. Made wealthy through his connections to the Pope, Archbishop Francesco Salviati purchased this Tuscan Via in 1475 in anticipation of becoming Archbishop of Florence. Spent the next few years having it renovated in the Tuscan style while plotting with the Pozzi family to invade Florence. Sadly, this left him very little time to enjoy it before his inevitable demise. After the conspiracy went south, archival documents indicate that Salviati swapped his archbishop outfit with one of the residents of Florence, who was then lynched in his place while he escaped to his villa. Basically, he was kind of a dick. So he made one of his, one of the residents, like, wear his outfit so that the resident would get lynched instead of him. Nice. Great guy. And we're gonna be killing him soon. Francesco Salviati, we are coming for you. Let's go ahead and grab that treasure. Since we're like right here. Oops. Or get on the horse. Do that too. Okay. Now, let's go grab this treasure too. And then start the mission. Over here? Wait. Not over here. Hold on. Okay, hold on. Calm your horses. Literally calm your horses. Hold on. Let me...
Amigo.
Oh, thank you, my friend.
Over here, Ezio. We found Archbishop Salviati. He's barricaded himself inside that villa.
Villa? Okay.
Take some of my men. Use them to clear the fields. Then find a way over the wall so you can open the gates.
Command over my own army. A nice change of pace from the usual sneaking and stabbing. I
kind of like the sneaking and stabbing. Behind closed doors, with the help of Mario's mercenaries, subdue the villa guards and kill Francesco Salviati. Alright, let's do this. Using mercenaries, press L2 to lock onto an enemy, then press triangle to order your mercenaries to attack them. Alright, horse, you stay here. I'll be back for you.
All yours.
Yeah, like. Okay. We have anything in here? Hold on. Nope. Get out. You guys are taking too long. Come on now. We got time for this. Come on. That almost like cheating. Okay, who's next? Let's go. Oh, this is an archer. No, horse, don't follow me.
Ecco.
the hell are you going? Okay. Horse, stay. Come on now. Okay, well, I don't have time for that. Where are you gonna go? Wait, where? You guys are coming over here? Did you just jump? He did, in fact, just jump. Okay, now where were we? Don't worry, I'm not going to go looting all these people. Don't fall. Okay, good.
Now you die!
Okay, come on. Come on back up. You got this. Come on. Oops. My bad. Did I do that? Here they come.
They should.
Shall I send your remains to that Ubriacone, Mario? What's the point? There won't be anything left of you to recognize.
It's quite a plan you have. Spouting nonsense while you send these other men to die.
I am a receiver, man. What say you to this? Turn back now and I'll call off my blade.
Sorry, friend. You are on my list. Your fate is sealed. There's no way to treat a guest.
What is this? Guards! To me!
Oh,
look. Come back here!
Let's end this quickly.
Okay, that was easy.
He knows you come for him. Emerging only in darkness to meet with the others.
That answers when. Now tell me where. Faded of late, Vengare Conforto. Or Bene. Requiesta di pace.
This is God's will, okay? Charles, and grazie.
So did that resolve the conflict? I'm just curious. I totally forgot to let them in. Oh, who's these guys? Okay. That was easy enough. So that is everything in this area. Spirit. Okay. Our next stop on this tour of Tuscany would be down to here. Alright, first let me just head up here. See if there are any feathers in this area. Does not look like it. Looks like we're clear. Okay. Where's he? Arrivederci. Hey, hey. Oh, wait. Oh, no. Okay. Thought that was where the doctor was. Grab a couple potions on the way. No, it's cool. Got a treasure. Now, okay, our end goal, the reason that we're doing this is to go after Jacopo De Pazzi, who was one of the ringleaders in the Pazzi conspiracy. Pretty much already talked about him earlier, so I won't go back over any of that, but these guys were actually historical figures. Yeah. Back then, although the people that were in the conspiracy, the major difference though is that like most of these guys didn't ever actually escape from Florence after the conspiracy, like after it failed. Like most of them were lynched before they even left the city after it happened, so there was a little bit of dramatic license taken with that. Just to like make the story a little bit more involved, like actually give you a reason to head out and everything. Wait, first we'll hit the viewpoint. And we've got a church coming up. Oh, and we've got a glyph on that. Okay. Monte Oliveto Maggiore. Founded in 1333 by Bernardo Ptolemy, the monastery of Montalvito Maggiore is Benedictine in practice. Benedictine monks are the most mainstream, practicing peace, prayer, and work, living in autonomous communities with their own local government. Montalvito Maggiore owned most of the land in the Siena region, so having its own private government would come in handy when dealing with such riches, as would a good lawyer. Fortunately, Bernardo Ptolemy was a jurist, leaving the monastery in a very lucrative state by the time that he died. Okay, so there is the guy that we're supposed to be talking to. But first, let's hit the viewpoint and find this glyph. In order to do that, we'll go to Eagle Vision. But also, I mean, just look at the architecture and stuff. I think that's kind of what makes it so cool. Well, that's part of it, anyway. So we've got another feather. Looks like there might be something. Oh no, that's just a hiding place thing. Okay, well let's get that part of it out of the way. Do the viewpoint. Oh, never mind. Okay. Then let's do this first. So that we can do the leap of faith. It looks like a little pyramid. Apollo. Okay, so we've got some kind of code, looks like. A cryptogram. Make sure there's nothing else. Find the eagle. Okay, with these formidable weapons, the adversaries of freedom plan to consolidate their territory, to exploit, to control, and finally to destroy. Looks like there's some kind of writing in there, but... Okay, so Apollo going to the moon. Apollo 11 photograph released to the public. Okay. See if there's anything else in here. Oh. The Templars? So the Templars were basically behind the moon landing. We've also got the ball there. Okay, that's Asperigo. That's the symbol for the modern day version of the Templars. That's Virgo. And we've got an apple. With Jack deep underground, it was easy. Okay, I'm thinking that's probably either 1352 or 10352. Either way, though, that is halfway for the troop. And we got more nudity. Okay. Let's go ahead and wait. We'll get this viewpoint out of the way and then do this next mission. This next memory start. Actually, go ahead and grab this treasure right here. The heck? Why are they making weird noises? Okay. Okay, I am apparently really notorious.
He's molting! Stop him!
Uh-oh. Try to disarm him. Ooh, that actually worked. Okay. Right after I said I was victorious, I get attacked. Yay. Hello. What's up?
There you are. Listen. We found Stefano da Bagnone. Just follow this road and it'll bring you to the abbey where he's taken refuge.
Wait.
Before you go, take these. You can use them to create a distraction.
Ooh, smoke bombs? Smoke bombs? Can we get smoke bombs? The cowl does not make the monk. Infiltrate the abbey and kill Stefano da Bagnone. Did we get smoke bombs? Yes! Okay, smoke bombs. Smoke bombs will stun and blind your enemies. Oh, yeah. Not even close. Okay, let's do this. What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? Identify the guards hidden among the monks. Kill your target before he takes refuge inside the army. These monks are really easy. Oh, snap. Alright, where is he?
Why are you here? What do you want?
Oh, there he is. And bam.
Now I will see who was right.
Where is Jacopo?
Nothing to fear, I suppose. They meet in the shadow of the Roman gods.
Ora si libero dalla paura. Requiescat in pace.
Wait, how's the target playing? He's already dead. Oops. I gotta escape. You don't know me. No, it's not really restricted anymore, is it? Whee! Whoops. Oh, I thought I did something wrong. Okay, smoke bomb pouch acquired. And we'll go ahead and... Actually, let's go ahead and take out these real quick. And we'll be done out here in the countryside. Save us some travel later. We're probably going to be ending this video soon. We'll do one more viewpoint and then we'll end the video. I'm not sure exactly how long we've had on this video so far. That was my bad. This poor guy, he's out here working the field, has his little chest, probably his lunchbox. He's like, oh, I can't wait until break time so I can eat my wife's homemade cooking. And we're like, oh, look, a treasure chest, bam, you're mine. It's kind of sad. Just say, Ezio can be kind of a dick sometimes. It's not okay to kill innocent civilians, but it is okay to steal their loot. Do we have any feathers? Does not look like it. Okay. So we'll just go ahead and grab this chest, and then we will be heading back in. Okay, actually, it looks like we've gotten all the viewpoints. Wait, what is this one? Oh, Courier's not... like that. That's how you do it. Alright, move. Wait, there's a thief in here. Get out of the way. That gave me the really weird noise. Alright, there. You guys made me lose that guy. They deserved it. Oh, I see it. That was kind of random. Okay, there. I am now incognito. Alright then. Have you lost your mind? Oops, I was trying to do better. Fortunately, they will just stand there and wait for me to stab them. Because I am incognito. And they don't know that. They don't know me. Okay. Alright, we'll do one courier mission. Hopefully we do this, and then...
Get this delivered on time, and I'll repay you handsome.
Okay. Quickly deliver these three letters to their respective destinations. Hold on, let's read the letter, so. Because this is fun. Okay, from Raimundo. Dear Vincente, I've received evidence to prove our worst suspicions. Your daughter is marrying an imposter. Although Leone claims to be a Guelph, he is in fact Florentine. This is further proof that those liars and cheats are trying to invade our government and further take away what little independence we have. If upon reading this, your blood is boiling as much as mine, I say we drop him off the Torre Grosse that will send a message to Florence, Gorge Raimondo. P.S. Once you have disposed of this annoyance, my son is of eligible age, as you know. Perhaps your daughter Tam would be better suited for his. Hmm. Dear Luca, I've been working to find a match for your daughter, but I find that most men in San Gimignano are weak and foolish, and those who are not put off by your daughter's displays of independence. Oh, and those who are not are put off by your daughter's displays of independence. One potential suitor was shocked by her desire to leave the house without a head covering. Another was dismayed to find that she had planned the activities for the day herself. This cannot continue to go on if I am to find a husband for her. Take out this dick and beat her if you have to, but make sure she is docile the next time I bring a suitor by. If you cannot straighten her out, we may have to consider a nunnery. Sincerely, Regarda. From Diana. Politics, politics, always politics. You swear that you were too busy at the court to visit your son, but that's a lie. I know that you do not want to be seen with him. How many heirs has your supposed wife, Bella, produced? None, by my count, and I keep track. You think that I am beneath you, and you may be right. But at least I had the courage to take care of your son rather than throw him out in the street, which many a night I yearn to do. Instead, I have raised him to be a good boy. He minds the house while I work in the shop. Now he's almost all grown up and the heir to your estate. And who do you have? An upper-class wife who commandeers your money, wears a wig, and parades around like a peacock in spite of the fact that she is infertile as a donkey. I may envy your money and your masculinity, Vincente, but I do not envy you that. Visit our son or not, he'll have your estate soon enough. May God comfort you during the endless winter of your fertility. Ciao, Diana. Wait, from Michelangelo. Dear Father, it has been almost a week since I abandoned my schooling. I don't expect you to understand why. I can't really explain it myself. But I feel the world flying by and I need to catch it to become part of its tides and currents. I'm not very good with speaking or numbers, but with my hands I can shape everything flowing around me, every moment, every mood. I know that you wanted me to become something more than an artist, but please, for the sake of my future, relent. As you have always known, I am much more interested in sculpting and painting than I am in studying. Now the artist... Domenico Gerliando, has asked me to join him as an apprentice. He just got back from Roma, where he painted a masterful panel in the Cappella Sistina. By Ricard, I might even be invited inside the Vatican, and maybe I'll get to see it. Please give your blessing to this apprenticeship. I promise to live up to your lofty expectations, and I hope that one day you'll be proud of me. Your son, Michelangelo. Okay, this is actually... I think is from the Michelangelo, the artist. What's interesting, right here he says that he painted a masterful panel in the Cappella Sistina. He might even be invited inside the Vatican and get to see it. Michelangelo would go on to paint the actual fresco from inside the Sistine Chapel, and like the most well known of everything. So, yeah, it's actually kind of funny. Ah, crap. Wow. Okay, so we need to get out of the city quickly. And we only have 2.5 minutes to do this. Okay, if we don't make it this time, then we're probably going to have to go in and end the video and pick it up from there. Whoop, sorry. Closest one. You're right here. No, whoa. Alright, we got this. Won't be so bad. Hopefully. We only have a minute and a half. Okay, we're coming up on this one. Hey, no problem. Okay, and now since there's only... There's only one left. We're halfway through. Okay. So it looks like we're going to be ending the video after we deliver this letter and finish this courier mission. Might as well get it out of the way now. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And also, check out my friends CMC the Gamer and Selena's channel, Strix Gaming. And we will be back with another video. Assuming that we can finish this one. Oops. I can just saunter over now. Oh, God. Hopefully they don't say, oh, yeah, you have to go back now. Ooh, that was 2,500. Nice. Here's your letter. Sorry, I just ran you over. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and end the video here. And thank you for watching, and have a good night.